Hello friends, this lecture is in continuation with your previous lecture series of CNC machines and automation. This lecture is to be taken on 23rd March 2020 in time 2 to 3 in your scheduled lecture. So what are the major topic of today is adaptive control system in CNC, types of adaptive control and application of adaptive control. Adaptive control is an important part of a CNC nowadays. Earlier it was not used in the CNC, but yes, nowadays it is working very well. So what is happening in the system? Adaptive control system is a technology which is automatically adjusting your cutting parameters. We all know the cutting parameter is your speed, feed and depth of cut. But why it is changing? Because a person who is sitting in Bangalore might be writing your program for a particular kind of operation. So in that case, he might not be knowing what is the machine up to, because he is writing his program according to his experience. But nowadays the machines are very versatile, machines are very powerful and their capacity has been increased. So in that case, the person doesn't know about it. The programmer doesn't know about the machine and he sent the program according to his knowledge and experience. So adaptive control system is a device which is introduced in the CNC machine which is automatically adjusting your cutting parameters as per your working condition. If you write the program such as your working conditions or your working material is titanium, which is the hardest one, but you are actually using it for the aluminium. So in that case your working conditions has been changed, but the program has been written according to the titanium workpiece. So your adaptive control system watch out that this is an easier operation, so it can change its cutting parameters accordingly and give you the optimum value. So that optimum value is that in which you are getting the maximum output with minimum input. That will be called as an optimum level. So it will make your operations to a very much optimum satisfaction level. So what happens in here is, so adaptive control system will definitely improve your production rate because it makes you optimized and your efficiency of your production system has been increased. Yeah, one more thing, in this adaptive control system is just not a magic. It is just the calculation or a mathematical formulation which is working behind your adaptive control. So some things, a formula or maybe your logic is working behind the adaptive control, that's why it is giving you the result. And those, how it is working on, we'll see it. But what adaptive control and where it is to be located on a CNC machine is this. You can see on this diagram, there's a block diagram. So if I'll start from the very basic, your tape is nothing, just your written program which is send it to your NC system. If I say NC system is your machine control unit, which actually read your program through the tape or the input from the computer and gives the command to the drive system. So your drive system is nothing but your motors, and then it is giving your movement to your table, to your tool, and finally cutting. Then we all know that in a CNC the sensors are used. So this sensors, the feedback of the sensor is given to your adaptive control system. So adaptive control is having its own constraints. It is having the performance index. Constraints mean your limits. Then the performance index, your formula or the logic which is working on to it. And then a strategy. Strategy means a path to be followed by the adaptive control. So adaptive control is containing all these 3 points. And then it gives its output to your machine control system, which is your NC system, and finally NC system will change its command to the drive system. So this is the cycle how it works. So every time you're getting adaptive control, getting the feedback from the sensors and giving its instructions to the MCU, and then MCU gives to the drive command. This is how it is working. So what is working steps or the functions of an adaptive control system? There are the three major functions if I talking about. The first is the identification, then the decision making, and next is the modification function. So in the identification function, what is to be identified? The current performance of the process. So in the current performance of the process, it is checking through the sensors, because we know that the sensors are every time getting the feedback from the working conditions, and it is sending its feedback to the adaptive control. So its first function is identification, means in what sort of changes I can make. That is called the identification function. Then the decision making, and he through the logic or mathematical formulations, it creates its own decision whether which thing it is to be adjusted, which thing is to be increased, feed is to be increased or speed is to be increased, correct, or depth of cut is to be decreased or increased. So it is a decision making. And then finally the third function is your modification function. So in this modification function, he actually knows about which string has to be pulled, which motor has to be started, which motor has to be shutted off, which motor speed has to be increased, or your feed is to be increased. So this is your third modification function. So all the parameters are changed in this function, this modification function. So this is quite important functions of the adaptive control. So if I talk about what are the different types of your adaptive control, there are the three major different types. First one is adaptive control system with optimization. In short, we call it as ACO. Next is adaptive control system with constraint, which is called ACC. And last one is your geometric adaptive control, that is called GAC. So this can be used in a short form or in a full form, depending upon you. So the first one is adaptive control with optimization. So optimization, as I discussed earlier, the optimization means you're making your process much more economical, with which you are getting a maximum production with minimum input, or you can say minimum machining cost. And how we can do it? So it is depending upon your index of performance. What index of performance is? MRR divided by TWR. So what is MRR? MRR stands for material removal rate, and TWR stands for tool wear rate. So this is the black box formula of adaptive control with optimization. This is the actual formula which is working behind the adaptive control with optimization. Because we all know that if you are increasing the tool wear rate, so ultimately your index of performance would get decreased. So it makes a balance between these two, your material removal rate and your tool wear rate. When it achieves the balance, then it gives the feedback to the machine control unit and it changes its parameters. So it is purely depending upon your material removal rate and your tool wear rate. And the next one is your adaptive control with constraints. This is quite important to understand, because in this it is purely depending upon your machine constraint. If your machine is highly capable, it can have higher feed rate, it can sustain maximum forces, maximum torques, or can work at maximum speeds. So depending upon your machine constraint, because in which he says that in the system the machining conditions such as feed rate are maximized within given limits of machine and tool constraints. So how much tool can bear, how much your machine can bear, so the maximum of all can be used in here. So maximum value of your feed or speed would be used in adaptive control system with constraints. But how will you get to know that I have reached to the maximum value? For example, a machine can withheld the forces of 1000 newton, cutting your forces can be 1000 newton, but I have to use this control lesser than the limits. So because he says that within the given limits, so maybe 900 newton, but how you will get to know that 900 newton is sufficient for this condition? So for that purpose we have used three types of sensors in here. You can see here there are TCM, which is called tool condition monitor sensor. Then we are having tool vibration sensor. Then third one is spindle torque sensor. So what are the function of these? Tool condition monitor sensor is used to check out the shape of your tool, because if you are increasing your speed or depth of cut or your feed, the first effect is on the tool. So if your tool is getting misshapen, or it just, you can say, broken out, so it will check out through a camera. The sensor is your camera, so a camera will check out its geometry change. So you will get to know the maximum limit has been changed, reached or not. Then we are having a vibration sensor, because at a higher speed the vibration would get increased, so the vibration should be remain inside a limit. So that is to be checked out tool vibration. And the third one is spindle torque sensor. This is actually checking out your force and the torque acting on your spindle as well as your workpiece. So the forces are to be measured through your spindle torque sensor. What are the different constraints other than these? Your speed, spindle rotation speed, means your RPM, the maximum or minimum limit. Then the maximum allowed torque a spindle can have or a workpiece can have or your clamp have. Then the maximum or minimum allowed chip load. Chip load, you know that the material which is removed from your workpiece is called your chip, and how much a tool can bear, that is your chip load. Then the maximum permitted feed rate. Feed rate is what? That how much your tool is getting onto the surface of your workpiece. The next one is maximum allowed vibration, as we discussed earlier. And the last type is your geometric adaptive control, which is called as GAC. So it is used for the finish machining operation. This is the only application of CNC which we are used for the finishing operations only. Means when your workpiece is to be finished, a clean surface is required, then this adaptive control works well. So what happens in this case, we are doing two things. The first one is cutting speed is taken constant. The speed of your cutting is always and always fixed in this kind of adaptive control system. But what we are changing is your feed. So depending upon your working condition, you'll fix a speed, but you can increase or decrease your feed as per your workpiece and tool constraint. Then the sensors are mounted on the spindle. How you will get to know about these things, what will be the maximum speed or what will be the maximum feed? So that will be known only by the sensors. So you can see this measure the tool deflection, tool misshapen, tool changes or tool broken up. So that will be checked inside here. So this is the third type of your geometric adaptive control, GAC. But what are their application or the advantages, you can say? The advantages are, as I discussed earlier, it will increase your production rate because your optimization is increased and your production rate will always be increased. Tool life will be increased. Optimization does it. Greater part protection through the different sensors or through your, because a person is sitting in the somewhere else, he doesn't know about the what is the maximum safe limit of your machine. But if you are using the adaptive control system, you will get to know. It will automatically adjust according to the conditions and can save your parts. Then less operator intervention. So in that case, your intervention would be less because machine is changing the things at itself. And the easier part programming. Why it is easier? Because nothing, if you are keeping a one feed rate, let's say 100, but actual conditions are different, so it is easier. And less time required for the part program. It's very quite understood. So these are the advantages. This is a lecture, and if you wanted to check this video, you can subscribe my channel, Tiny Steps.